Hello everyone. For this bonus episode of HPI Guys Workshop, I am going to be doing a nice unboxing of AMT's 1/25th scale race car hauler Ford LN 8000 in the Louisville line. Now this is an excellent kit. I built a version of this kit that has the dump bed and the snow plow on it, same cab, similar chassis, same engine and all that stuff. And it is an excellent kit and it goes together much easier than you think. I was able to actually assemble that snow plow kit, which I will link at the very end of the video. And I was able to do all the gluing and everything and get it into paint in just one day, just one long session of about 4 or 5 hours, I think. And it assembles so nicely. So we're gonna take a look at the race car hauler version. This race car hauler has been reissued a couple times in recent years because it's extremely popular and sells out every single time. This should be in stores right now. I will link in the description where you can snag yours. We'll take a look at the nice retro boxing on there. It's got that big honking fuel injected V8 diesel engine, cat in quotes, of course, right there for the licensing. It's got the full frame you'll build, beautiful dashboard, ramps, and it's got, of course, the race car hauler specific parts, which we can start looking at right now. First up will be the lovely decal sheet, which makes your life so much easier. You can replicate the box art without having to get anything out except for a white can of spray paint. We've got those blue stripes included, the Mach 1, get it, W-O-N, race team, license plates, sponsor callouts, Ford logos, not for hires, and of course those gorgeous strips, and they tell you exactly where they go using the instructions on the inside of the box. These truck kits always come with a ton of chrome parts, and being a race hauler, it probably does have a lot of chrome. This would be a privately owned custom rig. Open molded grill, gorgeous chrome on the wheels, got our bumpers there, our exhaust system, the stacks that'll come up out the sides. Now, I'm not sure if the manifolds would be chrome on that thing, but we've got our mirrors here, take care, they're very fragile. Our fuel tanks, we've got steps, air tanks, so a lot of stuff that would not normally be in chrome is in chrome, and you can just paint over it if you want to make it look like a workaday truck. Huge chrome tree there, and we've got this second tree. Now, I will warn you about all the AMT kits. The chrome on the trim rings, on the not the trim ring, but the ring on the rim, will very tightly fit over the wheel. But if you press too hard or you're not careful, you can split those. It's very common to have these splits, so just take it slowly and be careful. And we have the nice chrome ends to the fuel tanks, and you can see my face and that I'm wearing a Star Wars shirt today. Let me get out the other goods and we'll be right back. Some of the other stuff in the kit to help you build it up much easier, they've included transparent red taillights, which are always nice. One last thing I have to paint, we've got the main glass parts here, windshield, doors with the molding built in so that it will sink right into the cab. It's actually grooved in here. We've got our headlights, which do have some flash on the back. So if you're wondering why they weren't going into place, trim the back of the glass to remove those. And then we've got the back of the cab. All of that is crystal clear, no distortion, and looks lovely, and mine arrives scratch-free. We've got a steel axle to support the weight of the rear of the truck, which would be a little bit much for that. And then we've got the AMT instructions, which if you've never built one of their trucks, they are quite extensive. Though I would recommend that you at least have a few glue-together model kits under your belt, over your belt, around your belt, before you start working on the truck kits. But this LN 8000 kit goes together very well. One of the big tips I will tell you, and the manual says so, is lay out one frame rail, square up all the pieces that key into the parts you'll see when we get to the frame rails, and then glue one side, let that dry, then glue the other side of the frame on. If you set both sides of the frame down and try gluing the pieces and parts across, you could drive yourself nuts. But it looks like a lot of work, but you can see it's broken down into easy segments. So take your time. I think anyone could really get these together, except for maybe a super rank beginner or a young kid. But any teenager and up, any adult could get one of these kits together. Might take you a couple days. Just slow down, take your time, but you can do it. This one is not that complicated. And then finally, on the media here, we got these six sweet tires They are pad printed with Firestone logos on one side, nice tread pattern, and then no name on the other. So if you don't like Firestones, you don't have to use them. You can just turn them around. We get six of those for the front, four for the rear, and listed on the box, we get a set of drag tires so we can run a drag car or put spare tires up on the roof. We got the MH Racemasters. These are beautiful. I mean, Round2Models, AMT has some of the, I mean, I think, I'm going to kind of say it, the best tires in the business for models. I really do. They're just amazing. So those are included. So you get like, you know, a couple bucks worth of free tires. Now I will start grabbing the other styrene parts and I'll be back in a second. Okay, first set of trees we're going to look at, and always be careful with these trees. These are older style models. They put a lot on one tree and the gates are super, super skinny. You will also have loose parts in the boxes almost every single time. Not in the box, but I should say in the bag, because the parts are all bagged. So don't just tip that bag out on the table and let them fly everywhere, because styrene bounces like a rubber ball. We've got numerous cab parts here. We've got our backing for our brakes. With the little air cylinder hookups, we've got gauges for the dashboard. Look at that. We've got our firewall with excellent detail. I'm actually going to take that off because that's going to fall off in a second. We've got radiator and radiator shroud. We've got the halves of our Cat Diesel V8. I can say it. They can't say it because of branding, but that's what the box kind of hints at. Belt and pulley system, engine front, cylinder heads, oil pan, it's all on there. Their big rig engines are extremely detailed. Then we've got our driver's seat with its air ride parts. You can even see a little cylinder there. We've got the passenger seat, which is more like a buckboard. We've got our suspension parts for front and rear. These would be the rears. You can tell they've got all the extra leaves in them. And these would be our fronts. And they all key into the frame, so it's not actually that hard to put these together, like I said. On this part here, we've got frame cross members, multiples, beautiful dashboard. You can see where those extra gauges will glue in on the side. And these are detailed enough that even without decals, using my silver pencil technique you've seen in numerous other videos, we can get that painted. We got our fuel tank mounts, differential, drive shafts, extra long drive shaft right there. We've got some battery boxes, the air cleaner, and it does say Ford on it. Radiator lines, we've got intake, our air lines or exhaust lines, we've got our front axle, big beefy plastic axle, and we've got our mufflers for our exhaust system. Let me grab some other stuff. Sitting in front of you are the frame rails. As I showed in the instruction manual, the inside of the frame rails are all keyed. These are your locators for your parts that go inside the frame. So all of those, just follow the directions. On the outside are holes where you'll be mounting things like your suspension, springs, fuel tanks, all that. So it is done nicely. These are straight as an arrow. Do you remember the line from Grumpy Old Men? Straight as a Yeah, that's, I love that movie. So they could also call them straight as that. Beautiful frame rails on there. We've got our cab and our hood, obviously. Sorry about that. Started having a coughing fit. I think I swallowed a dandelion. Everything's blown around this fall. So we've got the hood all set up. It is two separate pieces. It's just molded together. So trim those off carefully. You can see that big air cleaner hole open for the grill. So you'll be able to see right through that grill. Headlight buckets. This is just a very classic work truck cab. Classic. And you can see the side windows have the grooves in them for those support pillars on the vent window, so that's pretty cool. The side handles, the mirrors all have holes for them. The other handles are molded in. Nice work on that. And then our interior, which does have detail on the door panels, but very, very shallow. So you would have to try to pick that out on your own. It's got a rough textured floor, so you can do it with a utility carpet, or I would just do paint it like a textured rubber floor in mine. And the other door panel in the back of the cab does have some ribs for reinforcement. I'm going to pull out all the parts for the race hauler and we'll wrap up the video with that. Okay, so we've got the ramps out. These are separate from the model, of course, because you can put them on the rack, you can leave them off to the side, you can make a diorama out of them. They do have a nice diamond plate tread on the bottom, and they are in the C shape for support when vehicles go over them. They also have these little lips on here. Don't cut those off. Those will attach to the back of the race car body and hang on there. This should be the top of the race car body, or the hauler body. It's got the diamond plate. This groove here is to hold those cool drag tires and other stuff for you. And then we've got this panel here that just closes off the back right along back there to seal that off as if you've got internal storage in that body. This would be the front. This goes right behind the cab. These are locators so you can install your roof and your floor. It helps it key together. This part is molding, so you want to snip those off. You want to have a nice flat edge on that side. Let's pull out the final pieces, which are the sides to the race car hauler. Beautifully done. Nice deep relief on the doors. Of course, they're marked on the back too. They are indented on the back. You could cut these open and build storage behind them if you desired. Pre-marked for you and everything, so you can cut them out cleanly. We got our rear bumper and mud flaps there. And that's where our tail lights will go through. And then we have a mirror image on the other side. Same doors. Nice high relief on those for detailing and marking in where your doors are. It's got great hinges. Each one has its own handle on there that can be detailed. And the opposite side is scored as well to cut it open so you can enjoy it that way. And finally, the last part in the kit, the single largest piece of styrene. You could also put these on your feet, use them as snowshoes in the winter. The bottom of the race hauler. This is where the car sits. The front tires sit in these grooves so that it doesn't roll anywhere. It has a diamond plate texture, smooth center, and this is where you build your cab and storage on the front. This is right behind the cab of the truck. You can see these holes here are for sticking those ramps in and bolting them on the vehicle, and it's got the nice deep relief. Guides the car on, doesn't let it slide. A lot of detail in these. That's everything that's in the box of the race hauler. You can see a diorama idea on the side. We can do our Mustang up. We can get the truck with the blue lines. We got our tires. Like it says, those are included. And then we've got our ramps. So this thing has a billion options in the box. Build it the way you want it. Enjoy it your way. There is a slideshow right after this of all the individual parts on a black background, so you can see them that way as well. And I will see all of you at the next review.